name's Mandy Howe, and I'm talking to you today about apples. We're in the orchard at the Prescott Farm. This farm has been here since about the 1700s. And I wanted to talk at the beginning a little bit about where apples came from, because they're not native to this continent. Wild crab apples were here when the first colonists arrived, but the apples that we know and eat and use for cooking and cider and everything else originally came from a valley in Central Asia called the Tian Shan Valley. It's on the border of China and what's now Kazakhstan. So the original apple trees have traveled very far. And when the early colonists came here, they carried them on the ships as seeds, as saplings, as apples to eat on the journey, as dried apples. Today we are going to explore making art with apples. It's really fun. You can do a printmaking with a lot of different foods. Apples are particularly fun because here's a variety of apples. This is a honey crisp, a red delicious, and a golden delicious. I'm gonna start with this one. First thing you're gonna do with your apple is cut it in half horizontally, like this. And you wanna use a big knife like this with a sawtooth because you wanna try to make one cut. Because what you're trying to get is a flat enough surface to roll up with ink and print. So I'm going to try doing that. And what you discover in the middle is this beautiful star. I'm going to take these seeds out. So here's my star. I have regular drawing paper. I have printing ink, because it's a little tackier and stiffer than regular paint. You can use tempera paint. And so I'm gonna experiment a little bit, which you should too. Once you've cut your apple, play around with it. You need to experiment a little bit to get the right amount of ink. I'm gonna roll up about an inch of ink. And this is called a brayer. So I have a couple of different size brayer. I also have some sponge brushes, and then I also have just regular brushes. So I'm gonna play around a little bit to see which tool puts the ink on the best. So a brayer, which is what I use, so you roll it up like that, till it makes a very special kind of tacky sound. I'm gonna put some more over here. Then I'm just gonna roll up my apple. So first I'm gonna go like that. See how that's not evenly spread? Now I'm gonna try my brayer. Roll it up like that. I'll try a smaller roller next. Then I can just start stamping. It's more pressing than stamping. You don't wanna stamp it too hard. Trying to get that pretty little star to show up. That's what I'm trying to get to print. So, as you can see, I'm experimenting with how to cut the apple, how to put the ink on, and then you can just start playing around and experimenting with patterns, with designs, to make wrapping paper, to make a card, to make a beautiful print. There, and see that pretty star? That's what we're trying to print. Try this. That's a little bit. Better. That's pretty. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to add some yellow ink to this, because not all apples are completely red, are they? Plus it's fun to experiment with color. So I can mix it right there. You can have any color apple mix simply. Put it right on the apple. So I'm sort of doing a pattern here. I can fill this whole page. So now let's see what happens with some lemons, because they're really fun, because they're soft. They're not quite as hard a surface to print with. So I'm just gonna roll out yellow. Use this little grayer. You want to roll it up so it makes a little tacky sound that you know that your brayer is covered with ink. I can just roll it up like that. You'll see this makes a very clear print because it's soft. Just going to put it right in here to further dissolve. I'll show you how to print with leaves. First, I'm going to make a nice green by adding blue to this yellow. I'm going to make a nice green. That's mixing blue and yellow makes green, right? So then I'm just going to take my leaf, same way I did the apple, and you want to pick a leaf that has nice veins in it. Nice lines that are pretty deep, so it shows up really nicely. So where the ink doesn't go is not going to print, it's going to be white. Then I'm just gonna press it down. And you can do it with your fingers, or I'm gonna take this other little roller and print it like that. I used a little acrylic paint. I used Speedball Rock block print ink. I used two kinds of apples, a lemon, and some leaves. Just make sure when you go pick a leaf, make sure you know what it is so it's not poison ivy. And make sure it's a thickish leaf with good veins in it. And just experiment. You can cover a whole paper with a pattern or design. You can make a little card. It's really fun, and the more you do it, the better prints you get.